Hello everyone, Alex here from warnoutkeys.com, and in this video I'm going to show you how you can enable load balancing and SSL certificate with HTTPS enabled for your website, as well as how to hook up your domain to an Elastic Beanstalk website server. So in the last video, we set up this very basic server, and if we click on this URL right here, it'll open up and say hello world. This is from a very basic Express application. The details of the application don't actually matter. If you have your own web server, then you can go ahead and upload it following the last video tutorial, which you can find in the video description. But to get started, we have to go to configuration. And to enable an SSL certificate, you first have to have one through Certificate Manager, and I'll cover that in a second. But when it comes to Elastic Beanstalk, they only allow you to use this if you have load balancing enabled. But you can essentially just enable load balancing and set the maximum number of instances to one, so it doesn't actually make a difference. So we're actually going to go into this capacity option. After we've selected configuration, clicking on edit, we can then see environment type is single instance by default. We want to select load balanced. It'll then go through and set up all the settings for us. We see instances minimum is 1 and maximum is 4. We want to change that to 1. That way the pricing doesn't actually change whatsoever. And if you do want to enable load balancing, so whenever there's high traffic to your website, it automatically scales. Obviously, you can change this max setup. However, for the scope of this tutorial, the main reason why I'm enabling load balancing is so I can actually enable an SSL certificate. So I'm not going to be going into the details of this load balancing feature here. If that is something you guys are interested in me covering, please leave a comment down below and I'll try and get to that as soon as I can. So once we have that changed, we can scroll all the way down and click on apply. We then get set to a page like this with a warning. This is basically just a confirmation screen. We can click on confirm right here. And then it'll go through the setup of actually making that change. So this might take a few minutes. So after that, we now see a check mark here and everything is okay. If we visit our URL, we see everything still works. Now, if we go to a configuration, we now see load balancer is enabled. And beforehand, we didn't have this option. We can click on edit. Scrolling up, we see listeners. So what this means is that the port on port 80 will be listened to by Elastic Beanstalk, and it's going to listen for HTTP requests, and then it's going to route that to port 80 on our instance. Now the instance port is both 80 here for both HTTP and HTTPS. The reason for that is that that is where the reverse proxy is going to be listening, and that's going to then route that to the actual port. Basically, this means that Elastic Beanstalk will take things from port 80 and send that to our actual web server. Now the same concept applies when it comes to SSL. So port 443, which is the default SSL port, will be listened to and it'll accept only HTTPS connections. And then once Elastic Beanstalk says, okay, the certificate is valid, it will then route that traffic to our actual reverse proxy, which Elastic Beanstalk handles, and then sends that to the actual web server. So to do that, we have to add port 443. So you can click on add listener. And then the top one will be 443. I get an error saying this must be unique because I already have one listening on 443. You won't get this error. Listener protocol will be HTTPS. The instance port will be 80 and the instance protocol will be HTTP. Then you can select a certificate. And if you don't have one, you can go to the certificate manager. And this is assuming you already have a hosted zone set up. And assuming you're watching this video, that means you probably already do. So if you don't, go ahead and set up a hosted zone. It's actually fairly simple. But if you do, then we can go back to the certificate manager. We can request a certificate. We want a public certificate. We can then click on request a certificate. We can enter our domains such as warrenoffkeys.com. We can add another domain name such as wildcard.warrenoffkeys.com. This will allow me to have www or API or any other type of subdomain. We can then click on next. We want DNS validation. And if you go through this process and it's not working for some reason, try email validation. It will send an email to the actual email attached to this domain, but we're gonna use DNS validation. We would click on next. We don't want any tags. We're gonna click on review. You would then click on confirm and request and follow those steps. But because I already have this set up, I'm not gonna actually do that. So I'll click on cancel. If you do need any help with either of these two steps, then go ahead and leave a comment or join the Warnoff Keys Discord server and I can help you one-on-one there. So we can go back to Elastic Beanstalk. We can select the certificate we want and we can click on add. However, I already have mine set up, so I'll click on cancel. So once you have this set up, now you want to actually go into Route 53 and point your domain towards Elastic Beanstalk. So we can go to Route 53. I can create a record set. The name will be blank. We're going to use an alias. And when we click on here, it'll show us a couple of different options we have. We can select Tutorial Demo Env 1, which is actually the name of our project right here. So we can select that right there. And then click on Create. And then we want to create another record set with the name being www. The alias is yes. And we want to select the same exact one, Tutorial Demo right there. Click on Create. Now it might take a few minutes for this to actually go into effect. But once it is, we should be able to see warnoffkeys.com and HTTPS warnoffkeys.com actually load our website. So if we open a new tab and we navigate to warnoffkeys.com, we see Hello World. And if we navigate to www, we also see Hello World. Now, if we use https://, we then see Hello World and we are secure here. And then the final check would be HTTPS with www, and that works as well. So we've now successfully linked our domain with HTTPS and load balancing. However, we didn't go into too much detail with that, but this is how you're going to set up SSL using a custom domain name with your Elastic Beanstalk environment. Thanks for watching this AWS tutorial. If you need help or have a video request, be sure to leave a comment down below or ask in the Warnoff Keys Discord, which can be found in the video description. If you want to learn more about AWS, consider clicking on one of the videos you see on your screen now.